Hey guys, today we're gonna be installing a trailer hitch on my 2005 Chevy Uplander. All right, so far we just put it up on some ramps just to get a little more clearance. We did it up here on the grass because those ramps were just sliding on the driveway. So let's open the box.
Action.
All right, let's cut her open. About 400 staples in this box here, so.
Cut the top off.
They even stapled this box in on the inside. Okay. This might be that free, well not free, discounted. Yeah, there it is. American flag thing is stick in the back. Yep. This was $15, but I paid $7 and it's made 100% of plastic. I thought it was gonna be metal at
least. Well, but, it's just a lightweight thing just so that you don't see a hole.
Right. And then here is the wiring harness. You can see the part number there.
118396.
Yep, and this is for the 2005 Chevy Uplander. Okay, so we're just gonna set these things aside for now. There's the hitch. And get this Kurt 4,000 pound, 400 pound max tongue weight. And let's see if it's got the model number on this tag. Not seeing it, but it's made in USA. eTrailer.com. They're not a sponsor, but they can send me some money if they want to. All right. You know, when that was a pivot point. Getting rid of that Gallant got me this van, and I bought the snowmobile with the money from selling the Gallant.
There you go.
Works out. All right. So this is what it looks like. Got three bolts on each side. Well, I should say on flat, vertically, and then two horizontally. Removing this.
All right. There's the bolt kit.
Hardware.
All right. Got a bunch of numbers and it weighs 1.3 pounds.
First thing we gotta do is start loosening the bolts underneath the vehicle. Okay, so here's the exhaust. And I've gotta remove these three bolts.
Which are 15 mil.
Yep, and loosen that one.
So you can move it.
Yeah, so this can move. And this is the passenger side of the vehicle. If my orientation is bad, sorry about that.
That was much easier.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I have to break the other two while you're there.
Yeah.
Not too bad. I think about it, I mean, all the rust, you figure they'd be a lot harder to break, but not bad.
I gotta break that one. All right, picked up the half inch impact wrench here, whatever, from my buddy Gary.
Okay. Would have taken a half hour for that one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I highly recommend an impact for this.
Yeah, yep. It's just a pain in the butt. That was so much easier.
Yep, so we got that disconnected. Moving on to the driver's side.
We're gonna break them first.
Right here, this one and this one, it may actually be coming off. These are 10 millimeter nuts. And this holds, your vehicle might not have this. This is a compressor, For the leveling suspension, and it also it has a hose inside the vehicle that you can pump your tires with and stuff. Mm-hmm.
That's what that hose looked like on that clearance table. Looked
yeah.
like something for this.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully this one comes off too.
Yeah, good deal.
I could probably use the impact at this point.
Yeah.
Compressor. And
I think. I don't know. Grab a. Oh, there we go. Got it.
Got it?
Yep. Now I just got to unplug this.
Okay.
There you go. And now we can just put it on the bench instead of having to do it on her back.
So this is the. That's pretty corroded there, too.
Yeah. That's why I said we'll just get a new hose.
This tab here is not going to be reused because a bolt has to go through about here. So I'm going to cut this off like that. That is actually the proper way to do it, apparently, from what I've been able to find with other people doing this. I use my Harbor Freight angle grinder here with the cutting wheel on it. Very nice.
You
get the right discs, though. That's what they're meant
right.
to do. Cut.
Yep.
So it's gone.
Cool.
So at this point, I'm going to replace the hoses on this compressor because they're completely, as you can see here, they're just completely shot. This T here, this end goes to the vehicle. So that one's already removed. I'll have to cut a piece for that on the vehicle, but you can see all the corrosion in there and everything. But
the light is kind of... There we go,
yeah.
I think. Let me just zoom in. The light is killing it.
All right, so this is the installation paperwork. That's the 13336 is this trailer hitch model. There's going to be three bolts that go straight up into the frame, and then two that go for the from the side. And the two that go from the side have to be fished in through the... frame, and here's all the hardware. So we're gonna have to crawl back up under there.
All right, there's two bolts, one with the finer thread which goes into the frame. These thicker or wider thread are for the muffler hanger, so that's why there's two of those different ones. So six of these and two of those.
All right, today we're installing the wiring harness for the trailer hitch here on the 2005 Chevy Uplander. This one's a little more straightforward. It's fairly simple. It's a nice little kit, easy to do. Let me show you what's going on. All right, so I've already gone ahead and removed both of the taillights here, and you just disconnect the light completely. It's a T30 Torx for the two bolts that hold it on. And then you feed the wiring harness starting on this side here. So let's pull it back out. I'm gonna show you. Oh, you already got it fed through. All right, anyway. You gotta feed one end through.
But you also gotta feed this end through with the ground wire.
Right, okay.
It's gotta go to that side.
So there's one end, you'll see it's got all this. Two connectors and a ground screw that goes on the passenger side. So feed that through along with the end here that gets connected to your trailer. So just push it down in through there. That's pretty straightforward. Now, I'm not quite sure why he hasn't disconnected this light yet, because it has to get disconnected. All right, so we got this light removed, and so this is obviously coming from the vehicle, and now we're going to plug it into the matching connector that's on the harness. So now it kind of splits it, and then we can connect this back to the light and reattach the light, and it's pretty much done on this side. So just reconnect that, snaps in, and then we'll just slip this back in its place down here on the light itself. And just push that down in. There you go. Okay. We're going to put that back in place. And like I said, we have T30 Torx bolts. We're going to use the little impact driver here to screw them back in. Need much. That's it. So that light's back in. The harness is dangling here. And now we have to feed it through underneath. Sorry, the hitch installation was kind of a disaster. It was giving us some trouble here with the muffler being in the wrong spot.
I think we're going to tie wrap it up here.
We got to put it through all the loops. So there's these little tabs underneath that you can fish it through, and then after we're done, we'll zip tie it. And then I'm gonna get up in here, so I'm gonna have to pull that up. All right, to make this easier for fishing, I just got a long piece of heavy gauge copper wire. I'm gonna put it down through here. Can you see it? Yep. So now he's got that down there.
We'll put it right through so it'll hook. Okay, now
perfect. That's
slowly.
Why I gave you the end with the hook. Yep. All right, I'm just gonna pull it up here. All right, took a little finagling, but we got it up through. So
I also found
here it is.
Yeah. I also found out that rust, it's not good in the eye, and it doesn't taste good either.
Yeah, no, I got some rust in my eye yesterday underneath this vehicle. Normally, when people are putting hitches on a vehicle, they do it within the first year or two, so there's not a ton of rust under it. But in this case, this vehicle's a 2005, and I've only owned it for about 4 years. So, you know, it's not brand new. There's a little bit of rust down there.
Self-tapper.
Yep, so we got a self-tapping screw we're going to put in here. All right, so we're going to switch out that Torx with a number 8 tech screw bit here, quarter inch bit, magnetic, self-tapper. Just
put that up a little bit, yeah.
Put it right here, and you don't even have to, you know, do anything with the paint or whatever, because
it's hitting metal inside.
Yeah, the screw is hitting metal, so we're fine. Flip that back over.
We don't have to attach it. It's already attached there, right?
Yep. That's it. It's a matter of screwing that back in. Put those two screws in. All right. So at this point, we're just about done. We're just going to get the zip ties, which it actually came with. We're going to zip tie it underneath, and the wiring's done. We're going to zip tie it to the loops that it's going through. Hope you can see that.
I mean, it's not really gonna keep it from sliding much, but it's in there.
Yeah, and then there's another one over here. So looks like we got her done. It's maybe not the prettiest, but got this little cap that we've wrapped around there for now to keep the wires from dangling. We could clip those little zip tie ends off, no big deal.
And I put another one in between to take up the slack here.
Shut them up there with the U-bolt.
Yeah, and because this is, looks like it must be an aftermarket muffler, I put a U-bolt on it to keep it from vibrating and everything. And yeah, looks like it's in. This is also the hitch installed too. Well, hey guys, you know, this was kind of challenging installing the hitch. It was supposed to be fairly simple, and it kind of is, but with the muffler being in the way like that and the hoses being all, you know, rotted out on the compressor there, you know, it just added to the challenge. And we ran out of daylight on the first day, and then we still had to do the wiring and all that. So, but we got it done, and we didn't finish shooting all the video for the trailer hitch installation, so I apologize for that. But thanks for watching, and give it a thumbs up if you still liked it anyway, and we'll see you next time. And I want to thank my brother Mark for helping me with this pain in the ass installation too.
You're welcome.
And we'll catch up with you later. Take it easy. Say bye.
Bye.